Pivot tables are a powerful tool in Excel that allows users to summarize and analyze large datasets quickly and efficiently. In this video, you will learn advanced pivot tables features for efficient data analysis. Firstly, create a pivot table. Select the data. Go to Insert tab, click Pivot Table. Insert pivot table in new worksheet. Click OK. Add the fields. Apart from normal filters, you can use label filters and values filters to filter with a specific value or criteria. A great option in filters is to filter top 10 values. This filter option is useful while creating an instant report. For this, you need to go to the value filter and click on the top 10 and then click OK. You can use Excel wildcard characters in all the filter options where you need to enter the value to filter. Let's use an asterisk to filter values starting with letter D. If you want to use the label and value field filter options altogether, you need to activate an option to use both of these filter. First of all, open the pivot table options and go to the total and filter tab. In the total and filter tab, check mark that allow multiple filters per field, click OK. If you have applied filters, you can remove all those filters from analyze tab, actions, clear, clear filter. In pivot tables, you can also use conditional formatting, which allows you to format an individual cell or group of cells based on conditions that you define. You can apply highlighting, gradients, symbols, and more. Instead of filtering, you can highlight the top 10 values from a pivot table. For this, you need to use conditional formatting. Select the cells from the value column from your pivot table. Go to Home tab, Styles, Conditional Formatting. Now in Conditional Formatting, go to Top and Bottom Rules and select Top 10 Items. Select the color. Click OK. This option is quite useful while creating quick reports with a pivot table. The other useful conditional formatting feature is to create data bars. It offers a convenient way to visualize data within cell bar charts. To apply data bars to a pivot table, add the salary field a second time to the values field. Select values and navigate to Home, Styles, Conditional Formatting, and Data Bars. Select your preferred color. A data bar appears in the cells. To remove the redundant numbers, hide them in the data bar column by going to Home, Styles, Conditional Formatting, and Manage Rules. Select the data bar's rule, click Edit Rule, check Show Bar Only, and click OK. Slicers are an excellent way to control your pivots via an external pivot filter. Unlike the inbuilt pivot filter, you can customize slicers and filter multiple items. To add a slicer to your pivot table, click on your pivot table and navigate to the Pivot Table Analyze tab, followed by the Insert Slicer option. Once you click the Slicer button, you can choose one or more columns to use as a slicer. All the options you choose are shown in separate filter boxes next to the pivot table. The slicer items filter the pivot table and display whatever is relevant. A slicer is beneficial, especially when you want to control multiple pivot tables simultaneously with slicer windows. The newly created slicer will only work on the initially selected pivot table, but we can modify the slicer to work for multiple pivot table that use the same data. Firstly, select the slicer box. Right mouse clicks, select Report Connections button in the slicer tab of the ribbon toolbar. Select the pivot table to be included in the slicer's control. Press OK to apply the change. Let's test the slicer. It filters both pivot tables. Similar to slicers, timelines are powerful tools that focus on refining data based on date and time parameters. They can be used to filter data by years, quarters, months, or days. To insert a timeline in Excel, a date field doesn't need to be visibly displayed within the pivot table itself. To insert a timeline, all you need to do is go to Analyze tab and in the filter group click on the Insert Timeline button and after that select the date column and click OK. Once you have set up your timeline, you can use it to filter your pivot table and chart by time period. If you add the new data to the table, you want to refresh the pivot table. There are two ways you can refresh multiple pivot tables within your workbook. The first option is to use Excel VBA to automate the refresh process. Alternatively, you can also do this manually. Click on any pivot table and navigate to the Pivot Table Analyze tab at the top ribbon menu. Click on the Refresh button's drop-down menu. Select Refresh All from the list. You will notice all the pivot tables in the workbook refresh as soon as you click this button. Any new changes will reflect in the pivot table. Calculated fields within pivot tables allow users to create custom calculations. This means you can develop your special metrics, ratios, and summaries that go beyond what the raw data shows. Let's add fields to the pivot table. Just click on any of the fields in your pivot table. You will see a Pivot Table Analyze tab in your ribbon. Click on Fields, Items, and Sets. You will further get a list of options. Just click on the Calculated field. After clicking the Calculated field, you will get a pop-up menu. This pop-up menu comes with two input options, name, formula, and selection option. We have the salary and bonus percentages for every department. We need to add another column to calculate the new salary with bonus. First, type a unique name for the calculated field in this example. The new calculated field is named Employee Bonus. Type the bonus calculation formula. Instead of typing field names, you can double-click on them in the fields list below the formula box. Click the Add button to save the new field. The new calculated field is added to the fields list in the dialog box below the existing fields. Similarly, you can create multiple calculated fields within your pivot tables to enhance your calculations. Referencing data from outside of the pivot table works similarly to referencing data elsewhere in Excel. The difference is that normally Excel uses a cell reference, but when you reference data from a pivot table, Excel uses the getPivotData function to pull the data. The function has two required arguments. The first argument, data field, name, or value that we are looking for. The second argument, pivot underscore table, is a reference to any cell in an existing pivot table. Additional arguments are pairs of field names and item names that may be used to describe the data that we wish to retrieve. Let's take a look at an example. We want to get the salary for the IT department. The first argument in the getPivotData function names the field from which to retrieve data. The sum of annual salary in quotes. The second argument is a reference to a cell that is part of the pivot table. It is a 3. Field 1 argument is department. Item 1 is IT. And we get the right value. As demonstrated by our examples, pivot tables serve as invaluable tools for summarizing and interpreting large datasets. They enable you to extract the information you require in a clear, concise, and easily manageable format. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more Excel tips.